Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to the science class. Today we shall begin with a new chapter, reproduction in plants. Children, we know that living organisms are different from non-living things by having several different characteristics. These characteristics make them unique. Like for example, living beings, they breathe, they respire, they move from place to place. They show growth. They need food for their energy requirements. And one of the very important characteristics is reproduction. The process by which living beings produce young ones. You must have seen the young ones of several different animals. A hen gives rise to chicken. The eggs of the hen hatch out into small chickens. These chickens grow and reach the adult stage. You must have seen young ones of cows, buffaloes, human beings. We are very common to see. Now, even plants, they are living beings, and the plants also show reproduction. Now, why this process of reproduction is so important? What will happen if an organism does not reproduce? Now children, we know that living organisms, they have a definite lifespan. Means after some years or in some cases, in some days, weeks, some animals and plants, they all will die, right? So what will happen? If all of them will die, then there will be no species left out, correct? So to continue the species of living organisms on earth, reproduction process is very important. The living organisms take birth, go through the young age, become old and die. So it is necessary that the number should be there, otherwise the whole species will be wiped out. So reproduction process continues the life on earth. It is very important to continue the life on earth. So all living beings have this important characteristic of reproducing to their young ones, to produce young ones of their own kind, similar to them, right? Now there are various modes of reproduction. In this chapter we are going to focus on the reproduction in plants. So plants reproduce mainly by three methods: asexual reproduction, vegetative propagation and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is the process in which a single plant or the single parent produces young ones. Here there is no involvement of reproductive cells. The special gametes or the reproductive cells are not required over here. Only the single parent will be able to give rise to young ones of its kind. The young one will be exactly similar to the parent. Whereas in the vegetative propagation, the higher plants, in the asexual reproduction, it is only the smaller plants like algae and fungus, all these lower type of plants, they reproduce asexually. But in higher plants also asexual reproduction is there, but it is called vegetative propagation. Now children, in plants there are two types of parts. The flower, that is the reproductive part, and the root, stem and leaves, they are called vegetative parts. So if a plant reproduces with the help of either root, stem or leaf, then it is called vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation, again we can categorize into different categories that we shall see in the coming videos. And lastly, the third type is sexual reproduction, in which the seed and the fruit formation takes place. In the sexual reproduction, there is need of two parents, whereas in asexual reproduction and vegetative propagation, the single plant can reproduce. In sexual reproduction, you need a male and a female gamete which fuse to form the zygote, which later develops into the seed. This seed can be planted and it will grow into a new plant. So these are the three types of reproduction: asexual reproduction, vegetative propagation, and sexual reproduction. Now if we come to see the types of sexual reproduction, as I already mentioned that it occurs in lower plants like algae and fungus. So these three types, budding, fragmentation and spore formation, are the three categories in which we can divide the asexual reproduction. Now in case of budding, the most common example is the fungus yeast. Yeast children is a unicellular fungus. It is made up of only one cell. So when it reproduces, that one cell, it develops a small projection, a small knob-like structure, a rounded structure which develops from the cell. It grows, gets the nucleus from the parent, and then later it detaches from the parent and becomes an individual organism, independent from the parent. Or sometimes these buds, they may remain attached to the plant and grow there. So that is called budding. That is very common in the yeast. Then fragmentation is the second type. In fragmentation, the word fragmentation means breaking into pieces. So fragmentation mainly occurs in the filamentous algae, the algae which have long body, continuous structure is there. These grow in the water, flowing water may break the filament into different parts, into several parts, and because of some obstruction coming into the way, that also can break it mechanically. And these separate parts, they develop into independent individual. This occurs commonly in the algae Spirogyra. Spirogyra is a filamentous slimy algae which looks like green silk, and it grows in fresh water. So it reproduces by the process of fragmentation, by breaking into pieces. And lastly, spore formation. Spores are rounded structures, spherical structures produced in mosses, bread mold, etc. These are having a protective covering, and when they obtain favorable conditions of moisture, they start germinating and they grow into new plant. So example for spore formation, we can write mosses, ferns also. Fern is a non-flowering plant, but it is divided into root, stem and leaves. It's a big plant but does not produce flowers. And as flowers are reproductive organs, so if flowers are not there, that plant will reproduce asexually. Right? So ferns also produce spores that are found behind the leaves. Brown colored sporangium are there, and in that small, large number of spores are there. And as the leaf falls down, the spores, they germinate into new plant. Children, I hope this video will help you to understand the process of reproduction, process by which living beings produce their young ones, importance of reproduction, and different modes of reproduction. In the next videos, we shall be studying about vegetative propagation of different type and sexual reproduction in the plants. Till then, have a nice day. Thank you.